Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. The Honorable Committee and Participant of the International Conference on Industrial, Mechanical, Electrical and Chemical Engineering in 2020. My name is Dewan Dono Bayusito. I'm from 11 Maret University. Now, I will present my article with the topic Solar Cell Cooling with Packaging Material or PCM for Enhanced Efficiency. Renewable energy is the future, is a big hope human life. But for now, non-renewable energy sources are getting decreased. Nowadays, to solve environment problem and increase the demand of the current energy, all of the scientists has prompted intensive research on the new things. One of the more efficient and environmentally friendly power plants with advanced technology. Therefore, the use of renewable energy sources as substitute for non-renewable energy sources need to be increased. Renewable energy comes from many energy sources such as water, geothermal, biomass, wind, and solar. Solar energy is one of the most abundant and potential sources of the energy be utilized, especially in tropical climates. To utilize solar energy so that I can be used as source of electrical energy, we can get electrical energy with the help of a device. The device is solar cell. Will capture solar radiation and become electrical for household, industry, etc. However, currently using of the solar cell has not reached good efficiency because solar radiation also causes increase the temperature of the solar cell. Increased temperature solar cell which result decrease in the efficiency of solar cell productivity. High temperature in solar cell can also cause damage to solar cell component and shorten the life of solar cell. Therefore, it's needed to do research in order to reduce the surface temperature to increase the efficiency of solar cell. There are two types of cooling technique in solar cell. This is passive and active cooling. Passive cooling, which cooling by utilize the surround natural condition such as unutilized gas from the wind can be concentrated to lit solar cell. Or cooling with water by flowing water and the surface solar cell. Active cooling is cooling which carried of force with other tools or material such as cooling solar cell using blower, cooling solar cell with cooling material such as nanofluid or packaging material. PCM has the capacity to store and release latent heat and can maintain stable temperature the process of absorption. The process of the phase change can change the state of liquid and gases by condensation and evaporation. Will change in the solid and liquid states are called melting or freezing. When the temperature around PCM rises to its melting point, chemical bonds start an endothermic process that allows PCM absorbs energy, and the melting material change its condition from solid to liquid. When the temperature decreases to reach the freezing point of the PCM, the bond will regenerate, and the heat will be released. PCM will return to the solid stage. PCM is thus described as thermal reservoir. Research on cooling solar cell with passing materials such as the research by Yan Su. The research is experimental study of using passing material cooling in a solar tracking concentrate photovoltaic thermal system. The PV module used in mini HTSS5 solar panel. The concentrator disk is about 1.2 meters in diameter. The photovoltaic thermal collector contains two layers in encapsulated PCM ball filled with paraffin wax and use paraffin due to the phase change in the temperature about 50 degrees Celsius when melting. The density of the solid and liquid phase varies in the range of 300 watt per meter square, 800 watt per meter square. Within this change range of solar radiation, the increase in the average output power of the photovoltaic cooling system relative to the cooling water of the photovoltaic system more than 50 watt per meter square. Next, the research by Muslim for the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Faculty of Engineering, University. About phase change material based cooling of photovoltaic panels. Okay, next research. Research by Muslim from the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Kocaeli University. About phase change material based cooling of photovoltaic panel. A simplified numerical model for the optimization of the phase change material layers and general economic evaluation. A simplified 1D model developed to simulate the performance of the PV-PCM system in Turkey as representative of the Mediterranean region. The results show the PV temperature could be reduced from 0.31 until 10.26 degrees Celsius, so that the annual average efficiency increase was almost 1.59%. Okay, next research. Research by Tahib about beeswax and patching material to improve solar panel performance. Tahib used 3 silicon monocrystalline, a maximum output power of 50 watt. First PV without PCM, will the second PV use paraffin wax, will the third PV use PCM beeswax. The research was from 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. The maximum intensity of solar radiation was reached at 12 p.m. achieved 1024 watt per meter square. The temperature of the PV modules increased to 28 degrees Celsius, while the PV panel with PCM was only 12 degrees Celsius. The electricity saving panel from PV without PCM between 7.1% until 7.5%. As for PV panels with PCM, the efficiency of 7.0% until 7.8%. Research by Brown from the Department of Civil, University of Dublin, about heat retention of photovoltaic thermal collector with PCM. This system uses 4 monocrystalline silicon PV modules with a power of 80 watt. The PCM used was eutectic with capric acid 75% and palmitic 25%. The first PV with PCM cooling, the second PV with integrated PV thermal system, the third PV with additional cooling, the fourth PV without cooling. The peak of solar radiation record was 1177 watt per meter square. PCM has been shown to increase the extraction of heat energy from PV up to 7 times compared to system without PV PCM. Conclusion. Cooling technique for solar cell system use patching materials. First, PCM is a potential candidate for cooling because of this is good heat absorption ability. Second, PCM is able to reduce PV temperature so that PV efficiency increases. Next, the use of PCM material still has a lot to be developed because it has more potential. Okay, this is the end of my presentation. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.